Hello, my name is Sam Chiedozie. Welcome to today's Open Heavens Reflections. I actually pastor a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God called Glory Chapel, and we are based in Newcastle in the northeast of England. Our topic for today is give wisely. Give wisely. And our Bible passage is taken from Genesis chapter 26, verse 12 through to 14. Then Isaac sowed seed in that land and received in the same year 100 times as much as he had planted. And the Lord favored him with blessings. And the man became great and gained more and more until he became very wealthy and distinguished. He owned flocks, herds, and a great supply of servants, and the Philistines envied him. Our memory verse is taken from Proverbs chapter 11, 25. The liberal soul shall be made fat, and he that watereth shall be watered also himself. Friends and brethren, the truth is that sowing or giving is the major weapon that can be used to break the power of poverty in the life of any individual. According to our memory verse of today, if you are not a liberal soul, you will not be made fat. And if you do not water others, do not expect to be watered back. Another version of this scripture says, a generous person will prosper. Whoever refreshes others will be refreshed. Do you want to break the grip of the spirit of poverty over your life and family? Then determine that you will stop being a stingy, tight-fisted person today and become a sower, a giver, someone that waters others and exhibits a generous attitude. In addition to all this, Pastor Adeboye further advises us to do our sowing and giving with wisdom, by applying a number of spiritual principles. First, sow good quality seeds. The emphasis here is quality seed. Therefore, the greater the quality, the greater the quality of harvest that will be realized. A great harvest will never come if you sow seeds that have diseases. So give according to the size of God's blessings upon your life. Second principle is to learn to wait patiently for the harvest to come. Different types of seeds require different periods of maturity before they can be harvested. Do not harvest your seed before it has turned to fruitfulness. This is no longer called harvesting. It is called uprooting. Therefore, patiently wait for the right time to harvest. Thirdly, sow your seeds in the right season. Breaking through financially requires deliberate and constant sowing. Many times, the right season to sow is usually when it is most painful and inconvenient. Close friends may even accuse you of not saving for the rainy day. Do not be discouraged, but keep your focus on sowing good quality seeds, and the faithful God will cause you to harvest bountifully eventually. A day will definitely arrive when you will say goodbye to poverty forever, and it will come in Jesus' name. Fourth, learn to sow on the right soil. The right soil definitely includes any giving that will advance the work of God's kingdom on earth, and any giving that will bring glory and thanksgiving to the Lord. When you allow God to use your giving as an answer to someone's prayer for divine provision, your own heaven opens up even more, allowing you to continue to be a trusted channel of God's blessing to His people. Key point, whatever you sow may leave your hand, but it cannot leave your life. Brethren, what I say to them in church is that the hand that gives always remains on top. May your hand continue to be on top as you give wisely in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you and see you again. Bye-bye.